In October of 2023, Notion released its much-anticipated Enterprise Edition, which grants businesses additional admin, compliance, and security capabilities. I've since had a couple of my own clients move over to Enterprise Edition, and I wanted to share some of the reasons why your business should also consider it for just $25 a month. Before we jump into the top benefits I've seen so far, it's important to consider a few things. One is that Notion themselves has said that the Enterprise Edition is a continuing work in progress, and that there are going to be more adjustments in the coming months and years as Notion continues to adjust their platform to be able to support some of the biggest companies in the world. Two is that there are a lot more features than what I'll be sharing in this video. So if you want to see the full list, go ahead and click on the link in the description of this video and you'll find all the additional features you'll get with Enterprise Edition. And I also recommend reading through Notion's documentation on Enterprise to see if it's a right fit for you. With that said, let's jump into the first item, which in my opinion is the coolest part about making this upgrade. The new Workspace Analytics feature will allow your company to gain insights on adoption, engagement, and search behavior. And this will allow you to fine-tune your workspace to better serve the specific needs of your team and understand who might be struggling with usage of your Notion workspace. The overview page of analytics will give you an idea of your user engagement, what is your most active team spaces, most active viewers, and who are the most active editors. You also have the ability to filter down based on time frames. So as you can see here in this photo, it's last 90 days, and you could make it so it's last 30 days, or you can do custom dates. For this example, I'm just showing Notion's documentation because it's just me, my workspace, and not much data to show it off and show how cool it is. The next up, you have the member engagement, which just shows you how many employees do you have inside of your Notion workspace over time. So you can see here in this photo, 38 active members. You can get a percentage of how that's increased over a duration, and then how many guests you currently have in your workspace. The content analysis is also really cool about the analytics. It's going to allow you to figure out what are your most viewed pages inside your Notion workspace and where you might want to spend most of your time on improving stuff. So you can see here, we get a view where you can see the total views, what are the unique page views, how many pages were created, and how many edits have been made. And then finally, with analytics, we have search behavior, which is going to allow you to see what your users are searching, and perhaps some of their searches aren't being met, so that you can create pages that answer some of your users' questions around these items. Next up, we have some added features around user management. So now with Enterprise, you're able to disable public page sharing, you're able to disable duplicating pages to other workspaces, and prevent your users from exporting data from a database. You also can put limitations on how your team is inviting guests to your Notion workspace, and you can select this to turn on a request adding for guests so that every single guest that is trying to be added to your workspace has to go through an admin first before being approved. And once you verify your domain in your Notion workspace, which mine is currently pending because I just upgraded to show you guys in this video, you'll gain access to a lot of these features as well. So you'll be able to access a manage user dashboard, allow or disallow users to change their profile information, set a session duration to control how long it is before a user must reauthenticate. You gain the ability to log out all users at once and also reset all user passwords at once. And then for those larger companies out there that want to enable single sign-on, you can do that through services like Okta, as well as you can use skim provisioning. But I think the biggest thing out of this is once you get that domain set up, that manage user dashboard is going to allow you to search and filter all users using your verified domain. You're going to be able to edit profile information such as first name, last name, email, be able to view which external workspaces managed users are a part of, and also be able to remove managed users from external workspaces. Another great benefit of upgrading to Notion Enterprise is going to be the audit log. This audit log gives workspace owners access to view user activity and troubleshoot issues that are occurring in the workspace. So if I come here and I click on event, you can see what type of events we're looking for. So anything from a page view to a page deleted, you're going to be able to filter down on that. Then you can filter down even further further by selecting the user. And then also you can filter down on the dates. This is just a really great way to keep a pulse on what's happening inside your workspace. And if there are frequent issues popping up, this is a great way to troubleshoot them. You're also able to export all of this data, if you wish, through a CSV. One of the problems with the other editions of Notion for businesses is that whenever employees are storing some of their information in private workspaces, that data can be really hard to access and find and share with the team. So that's why they've introduced content search, which is going to allow you to search your entire workspace, including private items. Now, you're probably used to this, the normal search up here. That's only going to include things that are public to all users or yourself. But yeah, when you come here to settings and members and you go to content search, you're going to be able to go ahead and find some of those items that are private, as well as it's important to mention for anybody who has left the company and has their data in private, you can come here to people and then recently left and find people who have left in the past 30 days, and you can transfer over all of their private pages to yourself, or you know, make sure just that they're in a public space so people can access that data. Just a great way to make sure you're not losing important information when there's turnover in your business. The last piece that we'll cover of Notion Enterprise is the new admin capabilities with the ability to have a workspace owner as well as membership admins. By granting a user a workspace ownership, they can manage everything in the workspace from settings to security, members to groups, and even delete an entire workspace. They can also approve or reject requests to invite guests to a workspace, like I was mentioning earlier. You can really think of them as like the primary administrator of the workspace, the one with the ultimate power. And that access of workspace owner should really be given out sparingly. And then you have membership admins who are more limited administrators, and they can manage user membership, and you know, they can add and remove members from a workspace and add and remove workspace owners, membership admins, and members from existing groups. But they don't have the ability to, you know, for say, delete the entire workspace. So by creating those two different types of permission sets, you could potentially save yourself a lot of headache for your business. And that's it for my quick demonstration of some of the benefits of moving up to Enterprise. Like I mentioned at the start of this video, go ahead and look at the description and you can find this page that's going to give you a detailed breakdown of all the differences between the plans from Free Plus, Business, and Enterprise. If you scroll down here, you can see a lot of those Enterprise features hover over, and then also recommend if you come up here to resources, you go to Help Center, then you can go to Enterprise Admin and you can read through each one of these yourself and get a good idea if it makes sense for you to upgrade for your business. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like more Notion business content just like this, don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.